So, ya akhi, stop pretending to be high class by belittling everybody who has any objection to what you say. Either we clap for you and beat the drums so you're satisfied, and if we say something against you, we become nobodies, neophytes. You call them all different names, all different titles, all belittlement of the other Muslim because you are on a platform that we didn't reach, because you remind us in every opportunity that you have a PhD and that you are specialized in Aqeedah and that you got you from Yale University. I've never seen someone repeat his credentials in any given occasion across lectures in my life. No one repeats his credentials more than this. Ya akhi, ma'lish, humble yourself a little bit and don't take us as some enemies. Wallahi, we care for you to a degree that we want Allah to guide you, because we know that you could be an asset for this ummah. No one is going to take away from your knowledge and from the effort that you put. Jazakallahu khairan. Of course, it's appreciated. But the deen of Allah is not that. Otherwise, you can go learn from the Khawarij. If you really want to learn how to pray properly, how to fast properly, then the Khawarij were better than the Sahaba. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam described them that you will belittle your salah compared to their salah. You will belittle your siyam compared to their siyam. They will have rough knees and hands from constant sujood. Then he called them the dogs of the hellfire, and that the Quran will not go past their collarbone. So if you want to use a person's doings and his effort as a yardstick for his righteousness, and that what he's communicating to you is sound, then how will you explain the analysis that the Prophet ﷺ gave to the Khawarij, who were superior to the Sahaba in worship, but were among the worst of this ummah until today? Our religion does not work on these grounds. The fact that you learn so much does not mean that the fitna has not encompassed you. And how do you know if the fitna has encompassed you or not? We have standards. Look at any of the mashayikh, Sheikh bin Baz, Sheikh Salih bin Uthameen rahimahumullah, Sheikh Al-Albani, and currently Sheikh Al-Fawzan and Ruhaili, and watch their legacy from the day they started until now. You will be amazed at the consistency. You will be hard-pressed to find a fatwa that opposes another fatwa in a matter of a minor matter. Look at Yasir Qadi. He has refuted everything he taught in the past. The one who used to be jealous for the Islam and the Sunnis and be careful of the Shia, and how could you love someone who curses your mother Aisha? How could you be friends with someone who says this about the Sahaba? And then a few years later, he's standing next to them. I made some mistakes in the past. I made some inflammatory statements. I take them back. And now we're going to join hands with the Shia. When you see the contradiction over the years in everything, from teaching the Aqeedah of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah and the names and attributes of Allah, to saying, well, you can select from the four madhahib, and while you add it, you can also select from the three theological madhahib, the Ash'ari, Maturidi, and Athari. Are you kidding me, Sheikh? Yeah, Sheikh, the people, wallah, the people are already lost, and they look up to you. So when you open this door, he's going to go read one of these aqa'id, then he will never know who Allah is. Then he will come on Yawm al-Qiyamah and say, Ya Allah, I did not know who you are because of this man. You will have to answer for this. Because the shuyukh that you quote, wallahi, they don't agree with you. You are hiding under the robe of the big mashayikh. Wallahi, if they heard you today, they would probably not allow you to address a five-year-old child. Because you will cast doubt into his mind. So my brothers and sisters, as hard as it is for you to digest what we're saying, understand the gravity. The problem is that we are very passive as Muslims. We are very passive. We look into every matter and go in depth. When it comes to the matter of the deen, we become so superficial. Someone writes a couple of kind words, says a couple of nice things, tells you about the seerah, and we all just want to have a party and celebrate. There are bigger issues that you need to be aware of.
Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe and click on the notification bell. Like, comment, and share with friends and family.